March 1984, time 22:16, patient name Mr. Barry Morse.
Doctor.
What?
Dr. Barry Morse.
12th March 1984, time 22:17, patient name Dr. Barry Morse. Patient has an inconclusive diagnosis and has been treated with solitary confinement for about 15 days. This is a bi-weekly checkup. Dr. Morse, how are you feeling?
Cut the crap. I know how these mind games work.
You're going to start off talking about how I feel, and then you'll continue and eventually get me talking about my troubled past with my previous arrests and drug problems, but you don't know one important thing.
You know about your brother.
Are you mad, brother? How could you do this?
Dead Huntington's, you know what that means.
Yes, I know. He would have died with flailing limbs and not even knowing who he was, but you gotta understand, you could lose your medical license or even worse, go to jail.
That'll only happen if they catch me.
That's never gonna happen.
Freeze! Against the wall! Spread him!
Dr. Brady Morse, you have been charged with the brutal murder of David Strife. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be held against you in court. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford one, one will be provided for you. Do you understand the rights I've just read to you? If you wish to speak to me, do so.
I'm sorry for your current state, brother. I miss you.
Do you think I have a case? I mean, I did do the right thing after all.
I believe your chances of winning are slim. The electric chair may be your fate.
I want you to carry on my legacy. You have to kill the patients whose lives would be miserable without the peaceful embrace of the Reaper.
Bidding shall be done, brother.
Dr. Brady Morse, the Electric Maiden beckons you. Come hither.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't lie, Doctor. All you're doing right now is digging yourself into a deeper hole.
I am not lying.
Patient is being uncooperative. Patient will be punished with dining privileges removed for tonight. We'll continue tomorrow. March 1984. Time is 22:18. So, Doctor, has your short fast jogged your memory? Can you tell me more about this man?
I do not acknowledge any association with that man.
You don't have to marry him. Just tell us a little more about him.
That man is insane. The nutjobs in here make him look like Mother Teresa.
Look, if you can help us out, maybe I can help you out. You seem to resemble a killer, but I feel like you're more of the average run-of-the-mill adrenaline seeker. You know, there are strict punishments for murder.
I suppose what you are saying is true, to an extent. You see, it started when I was a wee child. I was always a happy kid. I never really had friends, but that did not stop me from being happy. I instead sought the company of animals. These animals ranged from stray cats on the street to my dog, Lola. I used to love talking endlessly all day to these animals.
Playing with animals at a young age is not an uncommon theme in murders.
Quiet! I'm telling the story here. Do not interrupt me!
Okay.
So as I was saying...
Wait. So, you became a killer after playing with animals? Do you realize how cliche that sounds? I'm honestly losing respect for you.
Well, maybe if you would stop interrupting me, I would continue the story.
Okay, continue.
Alright, so as I was saying, one day I pick up a random stray cat.
As one does.
And it bit me. I was shocked. That never happened before. Blind with rage, I struck the animal. In that moment, I found power. I felt in control. I realized I could control how the animals would feel about me. If they did not love me, they would fear me.
So what happened after that?
So then I started my ascent to power.
Okay, Shakespeare.
I began torturing animals so that the others would respect me.
The others?
Yes, the others.
What was the most amount of animals you've ever had?
8. A dog, a cat, 2 frogs, and 3 fish.
Are they still around?
No.
Okay then, well, continue your story.
I realized I wanted to be a doctor shortly after high school when I went to college. I went to a small college in Mississippi where I studied very hard and didn't make many friends. I went to medical school after college and graduated in 1978 with my brother. We moved to New York City, but I stayed in the South and worked in Raleigh, North Carolina.
When did you meet up with him?
I don't know, maybe in the early 1980s when he got transferred to my hospital in Raleigh.
When did you find out about your brother?
Dr. Morse.
After he killed my best friend, Josiah.
Tell me what happened.
Josiah was diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer. The doctors gave him 4 or 5 months tops. Brady probably knew him just as well as I did, which means that he knew Josiah was miserable. Every breath was agony. Josiah just wanted out, but I couldn't help him. If I did, I would have lost my medical license and had to live with my best friend's blood on my hands for the rest of my life. But if I didn't, I would have to watch my friend die a very slow, very painful death.
Well, what happened?
When I got the news that Josiah had died a few months too early for the cancer to have gotten him, I knew what had happened.
Your brother?
Yeah, this was actually more comforting than you might think. Josiah wanted out, and my brother did him that favor. I don't think it was wrong.
You think like him, and act like him. Who was the man you tried to kill after your brother was gone?
I'll tell you.
Alright, John, I'm going to put you under some anesthesia so we can run some tests. We're going to put some electrodes on your body just to test your vitals so you're all set to go for your treatment, alright?
Got it, doctor. Thank you.
Alright, John, this seems this will fit the bill. We're just going to inject you with some anesthesia and you're not going to feel a thing.
Freeze! Put your hands where I can see them!
Dr. Morris, you have the right to remain silent. Anything that you say can and will be held against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford one will be provided for you. Do you understand the rights?
That's my story. I will never say that I'm in the wrong. John needed to escape from his suffering.
We'll continue this discussion later. Go back to yourself.
March 1984, time 1:35, patient name, Dr. Barry Morse. The building is on fire and local law enforcement is on the way. The patient has not been seen despite efforts to contain all patients. I honestly don't know if we'll ever find him. This may be my final entry. He could be anywhere, committing any crime.
Freeze!
Ah, crap.
Dr. Brady Morse, you have been charged with the brutal murder of David Stripe.
Start reading!
Yo, you gotta... Wait, how do you start no, like a new one?
How did you do this, brother? I don't know.
The camera messed up.
Oh, it was
okay. Shut the hell up.
Go back.